Hello everyone, and welcome to another Innistrad Crimson WoW draft. And this is again a premier draft, like I said. I will try to rank up in this month, so there will be slightly fewer traditional drafts and a bit more premier drafts on my channel for the remainder of November. Okay, the rare isn't exactly first pickable. It's a fine one, but it's not great. I do like the Gutter Skulker is interesting, but maybe not good enough. But it is interesting on a take on this unblocking thing, an unblockable thing. But of course, you can't really. Well, you don't have to attack with this alone. You can attack with more creatures. I don't know if I'm gonna take that. I could just take the pacifism. I like the Bramble Worm, but I'm not taking it first pick. I could take the Flame Blessed Bolt, I could take the Imprisonment, but I think the Flame Blessed Bolt is just the safest pick. It's a cheap removal which always will be useful, and red is, you know, an incredibly strong color in this set. And now I'm getting past Rending Flame here, which is just an easy pick here, especially because I just took a red card. But it doesn't matter what I have would have taken there. I think Rending Flame is gonna have to be the auto pick here. Yeah, there's some decent uncommons. Other uncommons are decent, but yeah, I don't have to worry about any of the other cards. This is the pick. And now, okay then, there's an Odric. Now, it's not the greatest. It only can create you a number of blood tokens. It can even be zero. But what other options I have? It is a 3 mana 3/3. It's not great, but if it creates some number of blood tokens, it's gonna be decent. And I haven't actually played any white red decks. There are other white cards too. I'm just thinking if I should take the Paris Blade Trainee instead, but maybe I'll take the Odric if I'm gonna take a white card. Okay, I'll take it. I'll take the rare. And let's see what I can find here. Okay, more red and white. So maybe I should be red and white. There's a Fleeting Spirit and another Flame Blessed Bolt. Now, I actually will take the Fleeting Spirit. It is quite good. And Flame Blessed Bolt might be a card I don't want to play too many of. Against some decks, the 2 damage might not be that good. And I also want to have quality creatures, of course, and this is definitely a quality creature. It's gonna be a lot better than the Escort here. So yeah, I will pass this bolt and they'll take the 2-drop here. And here I will just take the quest over the Lacerate Flesh. I'm not that big of a fan of the 5 mana removal there, and this is pretty good 3-drop here. Militia Rallier, it's fine. There's blue. All the remaining cards, which there are still 8 of them, will be blue and green. But I guess I have already decided to be white red. And it's also an interesting archetype to check out now, because like I said, I haven't drafted this specific color combination yet in this format. There is another Olen Bog Escort. Now, this is mostly good if you have a bunch of training creatures, which I don't have here. I won't be having a lot of +1/+1 counters, so I'm not taking that. The question here, therefore, is the 4-drop and the Evolving Vulture, and I think this is kind of, it's a nice 4-drop. It's a completely playable one, but you can always get some random 4-drops, I think. I take the mana fixing now. Okay, so I have this decent green stuff here. Actually, quite a bit of them. But I could play something like a... Okay, this thing cares about spirits. I have one spirit now. I don't like the 4 mana. It's nice when you have... When you can play it as an... You know... As a bit flash, but... I'm not guaranteed to do that. I will maybe try this. I'm not a big fan of this card, but it could be something that... Specifically, the red and white deck could care about. And wow, I was actually considering first picking the imprisonment there. Now, I would take also the fearful villager, but now I'll take the pacifism variant here. I'm very surprised this actually came back from this pack. Well, yeah, let's take it over the many 3-drop. And I have here, well, this is a best of one draft, so the Sanctify isn't really, I think, a playable card. I'll take this Geist thing here. It's not that great unless you can have a bunch of enchantments, but maybe I will. I don't think I want to have the equipment there, but maybe this deck is one that could actually use the equipment, but I think there will be options to take that later on. Okay, so I got the trainee, which I also was considering picking when I saw this pack earlier. So white seems to be super open. I'm very happy now about the decision to draft white here. So maybe I'll take the escort because I won't be playing the festivities. I just don't like this card at all. So I'll take this, but I will put it to the sideboard for now. And if I really get a lot of things that have, well, basically training cards, then maybe I can consider playing this. Now there's a very, very good 7-drop rare, which is blue, but I don't have to consider picking it because it would be an option. I have only 4 red cards in here. I could still be like blue-white, but because I have an upgrade here, I can just continue picking red and white cards by taking the excellent removal spell. So I think it's better idea to pick the upgrade rather than just move to blue-white here, which may or may not be an archetype that is going to be open to my direction. Oh, and then there is an Olivia's Attendant. Well, there's that, but there's also Rending Flame. So this is insane, but it's a very good thing. But look at this card. 6 mana, 6, 6 menace, and then when this thing deals damage, I mean, it could be the combat damage, and you get 6 blood tokens in combat from this thing, and then it also has the very nice ping ability. So I would be very happy to take the Rending Flame here, but I think this 6 drop has to be the pick here, and I'll take that now. I am very sad to pass the Rending Flame, but I just got an insanely strong rare, so I shouldn't be too unhappy about things. Alright, so Vampire's Vengeance will be killing a bunch of my stuff, so I'm not taking that, but I will take the Belligerent Quest. I like it quite a bit. I have a bunch of 3-drops, but the Dawnheart Geist isn't really the kind of card you want to have in this deck, maybe. 2-mana, 1-3, I mean. No, I'll just take this quest here. And Unholy Officiant. There are some nice black and green in here, but that doesn't really help me. Should I take this thing? It's a Vampire Cleric. Or maybe the... Actually, I have no 4-mana cards. I will take the Shield Basher. I'm not sure how good it is. It's of course very aggressive, but it can be quite good in a... when you are interested in attacking and not blocking, this will be great. Now, this pack has multiple cards I'm interested in, but the Flying Haste for 1-3, so for 4 at the beginning of a combat, up to the 2 target creatures. Okay, so it doesn't even have to be this. This boosts 2 of your creatures. Okay, I'll take this. I think it is pretty nice here. And Grief Rider, Lightning Wolf. I think I like the training thing. It will easily pick up an extra counter, and it might even find a second counter too with some of my cards in here. The Marco Walter also is gonna be a decent one in enabling some training counters. So here, an interesting set of options. There are basically 4 cards I could still be taking, but maybe I don't need more of these 3-mana cards. I have to just take something else. And given... Well, I'm not sure I'm gonna play either of these 5-drops, so I could take the Piercing Light, but I think I'll take a 1 Lacerate Flesh here instead, because I'm quite sure I won't be playing at the Nebelgast, Beguiler, or the Heron Blessed Geist either. Now there's another option to take a Flame Blessed Bolt or this Lightning Wolf, but the 1-mana removal is maybe now the better option. Yeah, it is. I'll take that. There's the prisoner, there's a ceremonial knife. That's not interesting. 2-6. Now I might just take the knife. This is actually quite good with the, you know, the stuff with training. Okay then. How many spirits? Currently it's only 3, so this won't have flash. But I'm not gonna play 2 of these. I was just talking about cutting the one I have here already. So what's this thing? Take the. Well, I don't know. It doesn't matter. I'm pretty sure I won't be playing any of that. Okay, so all these came back. Even Vampire's Vengeance is still here, but it's gonna kill too many of my guys, so I'm not gonna play that. I'll take the Piercing Light. I think that's the best option. Although with 2 Flame Blessed Bolts, it's quite unlikely to happen. Okay, now I'll take the Wolf over the Lacerate Flesh. I have 1 Lacerate Flesh already, so I prefer the 4-drop here. And here there's a Mythic Rare I'm gonna take. And this time it's gonna punish me a bit, actually. I guess the good news about that is that there are 3 cards I would be very happy having. Upgrade, Fleeting Spirit, and the Catharsis. And then there are still these 2, I mean, playable cards. And even the Sure Strike is a card I could play. So I think the correct pick here, let's imagine I'm in a Pro Tour or whatever. Nowadays it's, well, in a serious tournament with serious prizes, I would take the upgrade still over the other stuff. But I will take now Mythic Rare because I want to complete the set, and picking Mythic Rare is the correct decision in that case. Now I have a very few 2-drops, so I would, and I have 1 Evolving Bulge already, so I think I want to have 2-drops. Now this is, by the way, a very good one for green white decks, but I definitely want to have a 2-drop. Yeah, I'll have this thing and hope to be able to train them a bit. I don't like the Radiant Grace. I have a lot of 3-drops. So this has training, and when this attacks, you may pay. I don't think this is very good because a 4-mana 2/2 flyer, I mean, that's very bad on defense. But it is a good offensive creature, though. I guess I can take the 4-mana. Yeah, I'll take it because I don't think I want to have those 3-drops or yet another Lacerate Flesh, not a 6-drop. I have the great 6-drop rare in this deck, for instance. So I'll take this thing. And, well, I'll take the Fearful Villager because I'm not interested in another copy of the Beguiler. And here, another. Oh, there's a Fierce Retribution, which is going to be the pick, right? It's pretty good. I mean, 2-mana to kill an attacking creature, and then if you are really, if opponent doesn't attack at all, you will get to kill anything for 6-mana eventually. Yeah, pretty easy pick here actually. And Waldron Estate. Well, thing is, I kind of want to just have still 2-drops, but having too many of these could be bad if I. How easy it's gonna be to train them? That's the question. I guess it should be easy enough. I mean, what I'm gonna take, like the Celebrant's 5-drop here. I don't need the 5-drop. I'll take the trainee. Oh, I got an arm the cutters now. Now I'll take it. How many creatures? I have 18. Yeah, that's no problem. I will cut a bunch of them, these expensive ones, for example, but arm the cutters could be really good here. I don't need a 4th trainee here. Definitely not. Oh, another Marco Vulture. Oh, there's also Traveling Minister. Now, this is a tough one. Man, I would really like to have this card, but I have a bunch of 4-drops here, and this is really good with all the training cards I have. I think this Traveling Minister has to be the pick, but man, I would have wanted to have the Vulture there for sure. What the heck is going on here? I knew something good is gonna come back from this pack, but the Upgrade was not the card I expected to come back from this. But this was the one where I took the Mythic Rare. But I was actually taking the Upgrade as my actual option there, and it came to me as pick number 9. So I got the Mythic and the Upgrade from that pack. That is insane. Should I take the 3-drop? or the, I mean, it's gonna be a 3-drop either way. I'll take the flyer, fine, whatever. This was an odd draft. How so many decent stuff came, so I won't be playing 3 of this. Yeah, I don't know what. My colors seem to be super open. Did I get a good deck though? Because, well, let's move the camera first. So, I have a lot of cards and I passed a lot of good cards. For example, another Marco Vulture and a number of others. And I need to still cut 10 cards. Well, don't think I'm gonna play the Escort here. So let's go to this mode here. How many spirits I have? 4, and I will... Oh man. I'm glad I can go back to here, this bug. I will never... For some reason, my... kind of like... When I want to click out of this view, I usually go to the bottom right. For no reason. Of course, I can click anywhere. But when you go to bottom right and you click the done button, it actually does register as me pressing the done button like this, and it goes to this view. Well, I can edit my deck still, so I don't have to play with this 50 card monstrosity. What I was checking out is that how many spirits I have, if I had any reason to be interested in the supernatural rescue. Well, I'm gonna cut my spirit, so no. I'm not interested in that. I'm gonna actually cut all this stuff. These and these will be cut. And then that's still, I think the mana base will be 8-8 and 8-8 and the Evolving Wild, so I'm not gonna even touch the lands. I will just cut 7 cards. Well, the Piercing Light goes away because the Flame Blessed Bolt does kind of the same thing. This I won't be needing. No, it's not really needed at all. Okay. Do I have more easy cuts, or is the rest of gonna... Oh man, I have to cut 5 cards. What's it gonna be? Well, I guess it's going to be the Ceremonial Knife. That seems really... I mean, it's good with the triple Parish Blade trainee, but... don't really think I can have room for that card in the deck. And it's gonna be some of the 3 drops. Now the Militia Rallier is quite good in training my stuff, so I will play that. But so does the Belligerent Quests. I guess I don't need the Fearful Villager, although it does combine with this, but... This can always block. It just can't attack alone. But I think I might even need to cut more than one 3-drop, maybe. I want to play the Arm the Guitars here. Okay, so how about this Griffwing Cavalry? I mean, this can make... The thing, how this thing works is that... Well, first of all, it works if you are very aggressive. So you must not care about blocking when you play a 4-mana 2-2. But of course you can, pay the 2 mana to make yours, let's say, 3 power creature. You can give it flying. And then it also trains this thing. But is it worth it? I just don't think it is. I'd rather play these other stuff. I have these Grief Riders as flyers that can get training. And also the 2 mana it says here. That's actually quite a lot. Not often you can, I mean, you don't always be able to use 2 mana. You might have other uses for your mana. So I don't think this is a very good uncommon. I would prefer if it had like one extra point of toughness or something like that. But this doesn't seem very good card. So I can easily cut it because I still have these 4 drops which are going to be better. Also considering all my training stuff, these will be better trainers. And okay, well, one of the 3 drops will go. What is it gonna be though? Maybe the Meniscus. It's the Meniscus. Okay. And then 2 more cards. Unless I choose to play 16 lands. Should I do a 16 land deck here? I have a 6 drop and a 5 drop. Well, anyway, I need to cut at least one card. I like the 4 drops because these are so good in training my things. I have, what, 3 creatures with training? Or is there more that I don't remember? So not 3, I meant 5, but I just said 3 because there are 3 of these trainees, but of course I have 2 of these Griff Riders. So 5 things I can be training, okay? Okay, then. How good is the Odrix gonna be? It has nothing else than when it enters the battlefield, I can make some blood tokens, maybe. Found among creatures you control. So this counts the abilities, not the creatures. So even if I have like 2 flyers, it's only gonna give me 1. But it's still going to be better than this, right? Because this can't attack alone, but it has the untap clause. But I think it's better to be able to attack alone. Maybe the Militia Rallier is one of the cards I'm going to cut. I like these more because while these have less toughness, the ability to make blood tokens is worth it. So I'm gonna cut the Militia Rallier as one of my three drop cuts, because that's the mana slot where I can make some cuts. But now it's the question of cutting like maybe a Lightning Wolf, or alternatively play just 16 lands. Or cutting like another 3 drop still is a possibility. I don't think I want to do that. I have only 5. I have 5 3 drop creatures here. I will want to have access to all of those. So maybe I can cut a 4 drop. I do like the mana here though. Yeah, I kind of don't want to go below 17 with this deck. Okay. Tough, but maybe it is one of the 4 drops. Maybe. I don't want to cut any of the cheap stuff here. I mean, this takes a lot of time to figure out the last cut. It's not easy. How good the Griff Rider is? Well, it is a flyer that will easily in this deck actually get at least 1 counter, given my support for the training here. There's a bunch of support. And just, you know, creatures that have more than 2 power. Yeah, so fine, I'll cut one of the wolves, and that's it. That is it. This is the deck. It's ready. Okay, well, it's not a bad hand. Don't recall. Well, I have a double caster. A red spell, but it's a 6 drop. So this thing requires 2 white, so I think I should get the planes with this thing. And, okay, that's a fine start. I have the trainee here, the Griff Rider here. Oh, they have a Pax on Pop. Well, I guess I can. I mean, if they have a wolf, and they could easily have or a werewolf, I can put the imprisonment there. Oh, why do I have to take? I mean, if you checked my previous draft, I mean that was an insane stuff from in each of the games. By the opponents, or well, anyway, I'm facing like a Paxong Pup into a Paxong Pup. Both of these will continue growing. Now, I did draw this, and I have the double red for it too, but it's so slow. I mean, I'm gonna take 6 now, and then I'm gonna take 8. I will have now. The only good news is that the opponent missed a land drop. is this even real? It doesn't matter that they miss land drops. They had this thought there. I'm not gonna have any kind of a chance here, am I? I mean, they're gonna deal 11 damage to me on the next turn. They have a 3-3-4-4-4-4. I have no blocks. If I don't attack with these guys, these are too small. Triple packs on pop. What a deck they have. So I can use the imprisonment on one of them and I take only 7 damage. I go only to 5 and then I will lose. Now this will allow me to do a lot of damage, so I can play the Grief Rider, assume they will attack with all of them. Well, I mean, I don't have to do the math, I can just see if it's gonna be enough. But I don't think it is, but for each of the, I will get a lot of counters here. Let's assume they have no plays. That's gonna be 5, 9, 12, but it's not enough. I go to 1 myself now. Yeah, even with the arm of the Qatars, I won't be winning here. That is sad. Because I can make this into 5 power. So I will have 5, 4 and 3 power guys. 5, 4 and 3. That's total of 12 damage. And 2 of my guys will get an additional counter. It's only 14. So it's not gonna be good enough. But they will get vigilance, so let's try. I don't have a mana for the Paris Blade Trainee here. I think it would have been if I had 3 plains instead of 3 mountains. I could play the Cathars here and make them go to a low life total here, then jump all these guys. Except one of the flyers would still be. Alive. But since they have that, it's game over now. But yeah, triple packs on pop start. It is beyond crazy. Okay, well, I do have a reasonable starting hand. Let's hope the opponent doesn't have an insane start like the previous one had. Because that's that's gonna get old. That is gonna get old at some point if opponents keep on having just like an unreal starting hands. Okay, they had nothing so far. Did they have a syncopate? No syncopate. I have my bomb rare here. And a pretty decent stuff. Okay, that will be killed by the upgrade. Yeah, they might not block it, but if they do, I will kill it with upgrade because I'm pretty sure they're gonna have a exploit thing, and then this will become a 4-4, which I don't wanna deal with. Okay, so upgrade that. It only transforms if they sacrifice it. Okay, next turn I can play my Shield Basher. What the? Talk about repeated uncommons of the same kind. I mean, the previous opponent had 3 packs on pops. Is this opponent going to have... is this opponent going to have... multiple Bilume eggs? Well, they already had 2 in here. This time I won't have anything. So I guess the 4-drop, I'm gonna just use a fierce. I mean, it's not a 4-drop. The 4-4, which they are easily gonna get here, I just have to use a fierce retribution on it. I suppose. Well, why not? I guess if they don't have an answer on the Olivia's attendants, it will be fine. It will be fine in that case. I think I will play the Griff Rider because they just drew two cards, so if they have a removal, they also could have a syncopate, which makes my six drop very not exciting. Not exciting play here. I'm still continuing attacking here. Still continuing the attacks here, and then I will play the Griff Rider. Because even if they don't have a syncopate, I could they could have a removal on the 6/6. So I'll play this, and that also lets me keep mana up for the Flame Blessed Bolt and I guess the Fierce Retribution if this thing will transform. Oh, it will return. Okay, no, actually, it will have Summoning Sickness because this comes from the graveyard, so it can't attack. And it enters the battlefield at the end step. Yeah, okay. But now, let's see. Cruel Witness. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, top card of the library, they can look at it and put to the graveyard if they want to. Okay, then. Well, let's go Olivia's attendants now. They don't have at least a counter spell up. I could use the Retribution on the Cruel Witness. But I don't think I wanna do that. I'll play this thing and force them to use a removal spell here. But they haven't had any exploit stuff yet. Are they gonna use the blood token to dig an answer? Okay, they didn't do that, so I assume they have an answer for this thing. Could be another, for example, another bleed dry, or there's a 6 mana sorcery removal. I guess they don't have a 6th land yet, but that's a matter, just a matter of time. If they kill the attendants now, I will use the Fierce Retribution on the Cruel Witness to start attacking with these guys. Because I think if they answer this, it has to be a pretty expensive thing. It could be Hero's Downfall, but even that costs 3 mana. But let's see if they let me untap with this. This ping ability is also gonna be great. I will create a blood token with those ping abilities as well. Okay, they can exploit. Okay, now they got something for the egg. I will get rid of. I have to exile a card. It's gonna be the Parish Blade Trainer. So now they have a 4/4. Well, it comes end of turn, at end, in the end step they will get it, and that's still 3 mana they have up. Okay, so if they have completely tapped out, this would be so easy, especially now that I drew the mountain, because I can kill the 4/4. Problem of course is that they might have something. Well, they have good blockers now. I mean, I feel like they have a counter spell. If I use 6 mana on this thing right now, it's gonna be so miserable. I'll just play the land and, you know, don't do anything. Because they have 5 cards in their hand, they're gonna have something. If nothing else, I can kill the Mind Lich goal here. And I play the land because I wanna have this ability, this flame blessed bolt still up. Maybe they will tap out on something or whatever, but I will use the attendance at least to kill the mind leech goal. If that's the only thing I can do here, it's fine. I'm not gonna play into the, oh, I mean, they have six cards and they choose to not use. Yeah, this is just funny. I get at least a couple of blood tokens here, so there is that. And I'm not gonna use the fierce retribution on the serpent when they have mana up. I'm almost 100% sure that they will have a counterspell there. Let's try this. I mean, they have six casts, they're gonna use that mana somehow. That's for sure. But sadly, they have the flying blocker. And a double block here will be bad too. So I'm just gonna have to pass here. And I will ping once. End of turn. I'm gonna see what the spell they're gonna play here. Bounce spell. Okay. So now I will be killing the Cruel Witness. Now that they are tapped out. So I can start attacking with the Grief Rider at least, if nothing else. They didn't care about the swamp, so they don't need a sixth land here. Okay then. They discard a Fret Throng. Okay. Well, it's pretty bad against the Olivia's attendants, I guess. But is their deck only instant speed stuff? Because that seems to be the case. Well, I guess I can attack with the Griefrider now. I mean, look at the opponent. They have six cards in their hand and six mana, and they chose to do nothing on their turn. They didn't even play like a two or three mana card. So what the heck is this? It would be very tempting to use the Fierce Retribution on the Biolum Serpent here and attack with all of these. Both of these would get an additional counter. The problem with that plan is that it probably won't work. So I'll just attack with the Grief Rider and see what happens. I could use the Fierce Retribution on their turn to kill this thing and then play the attendance, but I guess I can just do this as well. Let's finally make them use of whatever instant speed stuff they have. I don't get it why they have so many cards in their hand and they don't play anything. For example, this was a card that was in their hand. They never chose to play it. Okay. Counter target creature or planeswalker spell. Sure. That was one of the counters. Are they having like a deck full of counter spells? They discard a Stitched Assistant. Okay. So that means the deck has some better stuff than that. They surely have more counter spells. Scattered thoughts, main phase. That's an interesting choice. That means that unless the player land, okay, they choose, so they didn't get a. What was the fourth card? Okay, no, that the two lands, the two cards they didn't keep it was of course the, I mean they get to keep two and they didn't keep the lands there. All right, so now it's my time to do some stuff here, and I think the stuff I'm going to do is going to involve a fierce retribute. Not that the attendant is good, but they're most likely going to have an answer for it, so I can do now this thing. Destroy target by a Luma Serpent, and then I can attack with everything. Training will trigger here, and then they might trade with the belligerent quest, and then I can play the traveling minister, of course, later on. And now the Griff Rider can continue training the trainee there. I get yet another blood token. They will be useful once I've started drawing lands. And now the opponent has to play some stuff. They can't just keep a ton of mana up. The funny thing is that they do have 6 cards in their hand. They have also 12 cards left in the deck because of all the card draw and self mill they have done. Well, it's still a lot of, you know, a lot of turns for them to win me, but I guess they do need to start attacking me at some point too, and I'm the one who's pressuring them currently. They can't just leave all this mana up now, they have to do some sorcery speed plays. Okay, Diecraft Scavenger, that's a good one. That's a good one for sure, but I'll just trade with it, I guess. This will hand out the counters to someone else. Okay, that's gonna get bounced, but now they have, okay, they might have no attacks now. They might have a sorcery speed removal, I guess. But at least they are forced to use it now on the attendants. And then I can ditch my planes. Yeah, there it is. There it is. Not a surprise there. Okay, imprisonment will actually be interesting because I can use it on this thing and do some attacks. Although I think I will actually first do this because I have mana still to play both my 3 mana plays here. Well, that is just better to get rid of. They might have another, you know, bounce spell, this alchemist thing, they can return it back to their hand, but no, that wasn't the case. And so every card they will, every activation for the blood token means they are also getting closer to taking out. And but they have so many cards in hand. I wish I knew what are they holding up all the time, because they are not lands. They have missed so many lands there. I mean land drops. So they do have 3 of these eggs. Yeah, that's the third one. Well, I do have the Sigarda's imprisonment on it if they get to sacrifice it. Otherwise, I still have a lethal flyer here coming up. They scryed bow to bottom. That's a good sign to me. That means they might be digging for some kind of an answer on the Griff Rider here. And the Sigarda's imprisonment is not gonna be good against this, because when they sacrifice it, I mean, they get rid of this. I can exile it though. Okay, so they have the exploit now. But they at least tapped out. So they will get some good card here now back, of course. That's a sad thing. So they get the 4-4. But man, the opponent has 3 Biolume eggs in the deck. They are uncommons. That's so good. So they get to kill my Griff Rider with that. But at least I can attack. Well, let's first see what I draw. So I'm assuming this will kill the Griff Rider. So I will imprisonment. I will use the imprisonment on the Biolume Serpent. Then this will be a 3-4, because I can pump the Griff Rider. They will go to 5. Yeah, this is fine. They will either go to what, 3, or jump block with the scarp. Then I can still play the 3-2 here. No, they will go to 2 or jump block with the scarp. Those are the options. They chose to jump block. Now they do have to take into account the fact that they also need to win me before they get decked here. So killing one of my creatures with the 4-mana spell is not gonna be good enough. They have no blockers currently, and I can even make, you know, exile this thing. What a game. I think I'm in a good shape. So they chose to kill the 3-4 there. Do they have more interaction? Because I can train the Griff Rider more. Of course, with the Traveling Minister, I can just have easy time training. Another scarf. Okay, so sadly, they get to use this serpent now and get back, I guess, the Bleed Dry or the 6-mana, whatever it is. But so they had to, I mean, they have so many exploit stuff and the triple Biolume eggs. But is that gonna be enough for them? I mean, I might just win here. This will give me, but this has flying, this has trample. I get 2 more blood tokens here. That's pretty sweet. And then I will, of course, well, this has trample. So I will do this, because otherwise I want to, of course, train here. So they will go to 1 here, actually. That's the case. They will go to 1, so I can't imagine them winning here now. Because they also have to win me in before they get decked. And this is a 4-mana removal, and it removes only one of these guys. Everyone here is a lethal attacker right now. They have access only to 8-mana. And they can't even really use these very well because of the decking risk they have there. But yeah, this game has been so long. I'm also at 15 cards left in my deck too, because I've just, you know, this is turn number, I don't know how many turns it is. Of course, I have also drawn some extra cards with blood tokens, but a nasty one. I mean, it seems like the opponent has a really good deck, and now they are forced to do this, and they are forced to, you know, discard expensive removal because it's gonna use all their mana. Do they have some kind of mass removal effect? I'm not even sure if black has in this set a mass removal effect, does it? I don't actually know. But now they have 7 mana left, 4 cards in hand. And also not... They need to deploy some creatures that they can attack with and kill me with. Because, well, first they need to just stabilize the board. They need to deal with every threat I have here. Odric is just a vanilla guy at this point. It only has the ETB ability. So that I mean, they need to kill the Griff Ladder, of course. That's the most threatening card here. So for some reason, they chose to kill the Odric still. Why? Okay, that gains them life. They have a black. I don't know. Okay, that is good enough. I'm not going to throw it away with my blood tokens. Let's make them go to one. They need to have some creatures here, because without creatures they won't be able to win me. There are only two cards left. How many lands in the graveyard is? It is 1, 2, 3. What? 3 lands, and they have only 8 on the battlefield. That's 11 total. So they should have a bunch of lands still in the deck and hand. Well, let's see what happens. I have a removal spell on some of their creatures, perhaps. Unless it's like an expensive bomb rare that doesn't... Well... I mean, I can kill it, but they will kill my Griff Rider with value now. But at least I can kill this thing, so there is that. Unless they have some kind of a counter spell that works for 2 mana. Yeah, this thing could win me, if I couldn't kill it. Okay, well, they're not gonna use that for anything. So now, finally, I know that they have nothing in their hand. So this does nothing if I have nothing here. So when it dies, exile another card from graveyard. When you do, permanent loses counters and or -x/-x. So yeah, let's do this. So they need to win me before they get decked, and if they use the blood token, it's gonna kind of make them, it's gonna be make them deck out faster. And I still have, if I continue drawing some lands, I can ditch them with the blood tokens. How many lands do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think. 7 here, that's 12. I have 4 lands left, I think. No lands here. But they should also have a bunch of lands, because I see only 1, 2, 3 lands in the graveyard. No lands in the exile. I mean, they must have more than 9 lands. They could have like most of their cards as lands in here. It's possible their deck is like mostly lands here only. And they can't just win me with the time they are having here. Unless they have the blue card that shuffles cards back to their deck. Okay, let's do this anyway. I mean, this is the with the fleeting spirit lands in a card in hand, they are gonna be useful, but might as well. Am I gonna get decked here? I'm gonna actually leave the one blood token just in case in here. This guy gets easily first strike now. Yeah, they knew they are not gonna win the game. What a grindy game. Man, that took a lot of time also. Okay, well, this one is a good hand to drop. The removal and a 3-drop with these lands. Also, my bomb rare is waiting for deployment here. Opponent goes first. They are deciding on their mulligan. They did mulligan. I will, of course, not mulligan this hand. The good thing about the trainee, which I didn't really get to use in the previous game, because the opponent dealt with my trainee that had counters by exiling it, is that it does move the counters to something else if you have another creature. So that is making the card, you know, a little bit better than it would otherwise be. Alright, so I have a very nice. Do I even want to? How do I do it? Well, let's see. They have a death touch thing. I don't think they're gonna exploit it. So I guess I'll just upgrade it. Or maybe the Griff Rider will be. No, yeah, let's play the Griff Rider here now. Or I could play the Belligerent Quest 2 and then upgrade this. There's a lot of options actually now. What's the best one? I have two upgrades here. I'm not gonna play a 3-mana card here. Which one of these is the one I want? I think I'm gonna play the quest. We'll see what they do. Okay, they have that. Alright, well, I'm happy I didn't play the Creep Rider. It could not have... could not have attacked. So what can happen now is what should I do here? I think I want to use the upgrade on one of these things. Okay, I will actually use it on the hero here, because now if they block the... Now I'm guaranteed to get the blood token. That cat will be valuable. I don't care. Of course, they are not gonna block the trainee, I don't think. But if they do, it's fine. The quest becomes a 4-3. They have to deal with it. Okay, they chose not to block at all. Well, that's good. That's gonna get me a... Planes, just get done with it. And I'm not gonna discard any of these things. Okay, they had the angelic thing here, but not that great. I have an upgrade for... I mean, I still can kill both of these with an upgrade, and both of these will have 3 power, so it's actually not a bad situation. Oh, they chose to raise me. What the? They're really raising me. That's interesting. I could just kill the quartermaster, but then I can play the minister. But I feel like I just want to play the 4-drop instead. So be my guest if you wanna block. I mean, I'm gonna deal 6 here. Okay, they are raising. That is kind of scary, though. That is scary. So now I have to think about what they could have, like another quartermaster. But they can't deal 16 to me, now can they? They can have the white uncommon that gives plus 3, plus 3, plus 2, plus 2. So they could deal like a 12 damage to me. Yeah, this is tough. I kind of want to have the Lightning Wolf here, though. I'll have the Lightning Wolf. Yeah, they had another quartermaster there. But I can now block the Fell Stinger. They even chose not to do that. Okay, so... Can I make this a first striker? I mean, they do have to actually... Wait a second. I can force them to... I can make this a first striker. Or do I even have to? I mean, if I kill the quartermaster, they have to block. And they cannot... No, they can block the quest here. Yeah, that's the problem. They will drop down to 1. So that's not an... I have to... make them trade with the trainee here, which will move the counters to someone else. So I guess that's what I'm gonna do here. I'm going to use the upgrade. on this guy. Then I will have first strike for this thing. It's a sorcery speed activation, so you have to do it like this. And then I can attack with this and this. And they will block the 4-5 here. I mean, they don't have to block anything, but I guess it's fine if that happens, but yeah. And they can go to 1 here. But I have a traveling minister I can block with. And now this is gonna give the counters to the trample guy, for sure. And I play the minister here. So, even though they have a 4-4 flyer, I assume they are not going to have. Because this is a 6 power trampler. They just attack. I guess they might have this another one of these fierce retributions. Or, you know, Hero's Downfall, something like that. Well, let's see what they have. I'm going to... I'm gonna actually target... Okay, I'm gonna target this. Let's see if they have a Hero's Downfall. There wasn't that. So now they might have a Fierce Retribution still. But... Oh, I actually should have done the Lightning Wolf. But no, they are gonna... Okay, it's fine because I have the Olivia's attendants here. So they can kill the quest and block the wolf and they will get something. Yeah, they have that. And then they will block with that thing. They get back the Diagraph Scavenger, but it's not going to be lethal still. And the Olivia's attendants is going to be rather good in here. It also has menace, just in case it has menace, so that it's tougher to block. I assume they take the Death Toucher here, that drains life. I mean, that seems like the obvious choice, but they are thinking about their decision here. They would go to 7, I would go to 7-2, and then I'm down to... Yeah, now they chose that one, but I have this thing, so they need 2 blockers for this. And if they cast this, they can't attack with it. I mean, unless they have a very cheap creature there. Well, let's see what happens. They can still win if they have the correct tools, but they don't have a lot of cards. Now they go to 7 and I go to 7. But 1 mana is not enough for a fierce retribution. They just still choose... Okay, do they understand that this thing has menace? Maybe they have a 1 drop here. But even I would be able to kill it. So, I mean, I should just be winning here, right? What the heck is going on? What? There's no swords to explosives or anything like that. This is just lethal, isn't it? I can even give this thing first strike, whatever. What 1 mana card? Piercing like... Yeah, well... Yeah, okay, yeah, that doesn't do anything. So the game is over. On the play. Oh, I see the Mark of Walter here. I don't have a 2 drop, but I have the Flame Blessed Bolt here, so it's fine. Not sure though what to do with the... I think I'm gonna play the mountain here because maybe I draw one of the lands and then I know what to do. Okay, this is... a bit awkward, but of course I have to do this anyway. If they have a 2-drop, if it has 3 toughness, well, I guess there's not a lot of... Okay, it's all fine now. So my deck has double casters, are the Arm the Cathars, I think. Well, it is. And then the 6 mana thing here. But I have a Flame Blessed Bolt and Upgrade, so I think I take them Mountain here. Because I might want to cast them both on the same turn. Flyer, let's take them quest now. So upgrade. Or the bolt. Okay. Because I'd rather have the flyer here. I can use my own bolt. Although, should I take... Nah, I think I'll get rid of this. They won't draw a card because it exiles, and then I can play the minister. If nothing else, it will gain me 1 life per turn. Oh, that's a nasty one. But I'm glad I have operate, because that is absolutely necessary now. Oof, that would have just won the game for them. Because my guys are so bad. I'd rather deal 1 than gain 1, so let's do that. Okay, don't have more of this kind of stuff that are must kills. That will eat a fierce retribution at some point. And I won't be attacking. Well, I could. But it's worth having the Griff Rider, although... Actually, I should just do it like this. Use the Fierce Retribution, I think. I can play the Spirit and... kill this guy. This is a Sorcery Speed activation, so I have to do it right away. But I will use the Fierce Retribution here. On the Hook Hand Mariner, I think. It will be... They might have something even larger than that, but I feel like I just wanna kill it now that I have the mana for it. Okay, that is a lot less troublesome. Now what to do? I could attack with this because it threatens to have death, first strike. And if they have a removal or something like that, I can exile the Parish Blade Trainee, I guess. Because I want to play the Grief Rider and then the Mark of Vulture to start actually training stuff. So let's see what happens when I do this. That's fine. Ah, oh, that's a nasty one. They get three blood tokens from that. Don't like that. Oh, there's my bummer again. So I think I should just try to raise them. I mean, the Paris Blade Trainee is nice, but this doesn't give haste. No, it only... Yeah, so... I can deal 4 or I can deal what? 7. 7 sounds a lot better. Don't care about the trainee, I guess. I can use this as a... You know, if I want to save this from something. So, let's gain some life. None of this matters, really. Don't think they can do anything with 1 green mana. So they have to deal with the flyer, otherwise it will be able to kill them in a couple of turns. I can even pump it even more, so it will, if I want to, I can make it deal 3 damage a turn. And of course the spore back wolf won't do much, so they need more removal. And if I find some lands, I will have the Olivia's attendance, which will be very good. Okay, so they did have a removal on that. Good for them, now is it? But do they have a blocker on the Fleeting Spirit? This threatens to be a 4 power first striker, so that is good for me. Okay, well, I'm gonna play the land for sure, because of the Olivia's attendance. Yeah, I guess I'll play the trainee too. If they have a removal on the spirit, they don't know I have a card in my hand I'm not willing to discard. So I don't think they're gonna target this with anything. That is something that can't even... Yeah, they're not gonna take 2 damage to transform this into something that cannot even block. So, no problem there. Now they are choosing to... Oh, upgrade. So I could just win here. No, I couldn't just win here because they have the 3-1. So, but I guess if I kill this with upgrade, they're forced to... Well, yeah, let's try it. Let us try it. Huh. Man, that's a tough one. Oh man, they actually did have a Rending Flame there. Oh man. That's really tough. I can save it by discarding the attendants, but there's no guarantee that it's gonna be good enough if they have like a 6-6 coming up. I'm gonna let that resolve. It just has to be. Man, this is so annoying. So annoying. I can't even attack here. I thought I was in a good shape when I was able to kill their visionary, but that maybe, I mean, why not? I mean, don't go for the lethal. Well, that's not a bad. That's not a good. Now, usually you should go for the lethal if there's a good chance it's gonna work. This time it just, they just had the stuff. They... Okay, I'm gonna try this now. And then they need to have something very good for this, because a red-green deck doesn't kill a 6-6 that easily. I'm not gonna offer the trade here, because this will be trained into a higher toughness creature. Now, this was enough, which I suspected. But yeah, usually the rule is to go for lethal if the opponent needs like multiple things to prevent the lethal from happening. And in this case, they happen to have... Well, not exactly multiple things, but they... Yeah, I guess they had the 3-1, so a random blocker that is capable of dealing 3 damage, and then the Rending Flame. But yeah, it was against the red-green deck, there's not a lot of ways they can have to deal with the 6-6. So that's why I didn't end up saving the Fleeting Spirit here. Okay, that's not a keep. Only 2 lands and only 2 planes, and I can't cast anything here. I'm on the draw, I will mulligan this. And this is a fine hand, but What to? This is a tougher one to. Yeah, this would be a great hand as a 7-card hand. I really don't like to lose a land here, but that might be what I want to do. The thing is that the Lightning Wolf here is the thing that allows me to train here, but maybe it is. I mean, if I go to 2 lands, I need to get lucky to draw lands. I guess I need to just draw some creatures. So the wolf goes away. I want to have the minister and the 2-drop here. And of course the removal spell. But now this will be bad if I draw like multiple lands. But no, this now that was fantastic. Now I'm very happy about the choice to get rid of the wolf here. So let's just attack here. Attack for 1. Still nothing up. Well, let's see if this works. I mean, this shield passer and the mountain, these were amazing, amazing draws. This curve is perfect, but the opponent is gonna have something that interferes with my plays for sure. But I had 1-drop, 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop here. That is sad. They had no play on turn 3 either. Now they have a specimen here. What the heck is going on here? Wow. I guess they now are gonna remove the rider, otherwise the training will trigger here. I get to 2-3 here. Well, that was nice. And then I can play the sealed passer. Yeah, they can do that and return it. But if that's the play they're gonna have on this turn. Wow, it's not. I mean, maybe they have a mass removal effect. I don't know if they have, but if their play is gonna be returning these. What are the cards in their hand? Something very expensive stuff. I guess that is just that can't even drain me. This becomes indestructible. They can kill the blade. Parish Blade training, but I will get counters on both of these training things, and this will give 2 counters to someone else. This is not the spot to use the Arm the Cathars. I don't think it is. No, it's not. So this will pump something. It's the flyer. We'll get the counter from the shield bearer anyway. And then this is an attack trigger, right? Yep. That's right. And then who gets the counters? That is an interesting question, actually. That is a very interesting question. I think the flyer is more threatening here, so I'll give them to the shield passer, but I could also give them to the traveling minister. That's not a completely bad of an idea either. So it will be 2 counters. Now I'll give it to the shield passer. Because actually the flyer will be lethal if they use like a 5 mana sorcery spell to kill this. But they have this. What does it do? Haste. When it attacks, it can kill the traveling minister, right? Then I can kill it, because why not? But I lose 1 minister, but it doesn't matter because the Arm the Cathars means that this gets plus 3 on this, I get plus 2 and yep, that's lethal now. So that was a weird game because the opponent didn't do anything before turn 4. And the play they had on turn 4 was persistent specimen, which they then returned because they jump blocked with it. Weird stuff. Okay, man, what a hand. I do have the 2 flame blessed bolts, but that's all the hand does. It doesn't apply any kind of pressure, so I have to mulligan this. And this is a lot better, and I'm gonna lose the... Actually, the Cathars is gonna be the least useful card in here. Now, it's not a great hand, but opponent mulliganed to 6 as well, so maybe that's some bonus. It's not a great hand, but it is a hand that can, you know, do stuff. Hopefully I do find the 4th land. Okay, well, that I'm not gonna kill that, because unless I could exile it. Well, at least I got a quest in here. But yeah, this could be problematic if they have like a ton of these guys. The 2-1s are pretty decent against my deck. Okay, that's gonna find a non-creature from top 6 cards. Okay, Rending Flame. Well, oh man. They played a 2-1 that gave them a card, and then they block with a Fret Strong, which is gonna give them a card. I think I'm still gonna do it, because this Rending Flame will kill my Walter, but let's just attack for a few points of damage here. It's gonna be trampling a bunch here, so... and I get their Blood Token here, so... if I keep drawing some useless lands, I can... you know, swap them into actual spells, but yeah, they of course did have a Wretched Throng in there, and then they will just kill my Walter, will they? I guess I can kill the 2-1 with the Lacerate Flesh and have a lot of blood tokens. Okay, they have the Mythic Red, which this even so it does. You may cast a spell from the top of your library if it... Yeah, okay, well, let's... I mean, kill it, right? I guess I have to kill it. So, how do I do it? I have to kill it right away, so let's do that. I wonder if they attack with this thing. Should I kill it just for curb reasons? They are stuck at 3 here, but they have the Rending Flame here. I think I will leave the Retribution for later. Yeah, I'm not gonna use this on the 2-1. I will try to raise them. That dies. Okay, Flame Blessed Bolt can get rid of this guy. I mean, all of these cards can get rid of it. But let's see if they have more removal. And they... well, they had a decent bounce spell tempo-wise. I can't say I'm happy about that. Well, I think I'm just playing these and probably use the flame blessed bolt on the throng. They might still have more of these and I'd rather exile it so they don't get a trigger, and then I can deal with the 2-1 flyer at some point if it feels necessary. Even it might not be necessary because I have a 4 power creature which just beats this in combat, and I'm also winning the race here. But now let's see if they can kill this. If they have a kill spell on the wolf, I think then I will be in trouble. It's my only thing that can deal actual damage. Okay. Well, that will be getting killed, so I'll kill the throng, I think, just to be mana efficient here. Well, let's do that. Oh, they have a 1 mana spell. That must mean that. Alright, I don't think I wanna... But let's do this now. They can have the bounce your own creature thing here. That is a possibility. Don't know what else they can have for 1 blue mana. Yeah. I don't get my blood token, but I guess I have 1 already, and I can use the fierce retribution on that, or I can just make this, you know, first striker, but let's first see what they do and what I draw. They still are nowhere near out of spells here. They have missed land drops, so that means they, I think that means they do have four spells in their hand, one of which I know about. Okay, they can sack that to get a rending flame back. Very sad. Especially if... Oh, they chose to get a lunar rejection instead. Well, I can make this a first striker. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, it's not so bad because I drew a 2 mana card. They're gonna definitely bounce it, but it's... and they're gonna draw a card, but I have to get rid of that thing anyway. And I can use the retribution to kill something for cheap. Yeah, it's not so bad. Okay, the statue. Interesting. Do they have a counter spell? Well, syncopate won't work because I have the extra mana here. So let's just play this. They have the mana leak? No, they don't. Well, that's good. Well, they of course had that. No, actually they didn't. No, they didn't. So they had a second rending flame in their hand. Yeah, they, because they returned the lunar rejection with the scarab, but instead of the rending flame, but they did have another rending flame in their hand. That is pretty crazy stuff, actually. I'm gonna kill that. Just to not take too much damage here, but yeah, look at the stuff they had here. It's too much. I can kill that thing, but oh man, yeah, I'm gonna lose this game. They just had too much stuff, and they even blocked the 1-2. They didn't have to do that, but I guess the 5-5 they will eventually have, and whatever it is, the spells they still have in their hand is enough to win them the game. But let's see if I draw my bomb rare, the menace guy. If I do that, or is it the gal? Well, anyway, okay, 2-5 flyer, draw a card. Not good. I need my bomb rare and I need them to not have a counter spell for it. Because this will be a 5-5 on the next turn. Yeah, it feels like they have a syncopate in their hand, so even if I draw my thing, is gonna be bad. Yeah, now they have what, 5 power of flyers and the 5-5 ground guy. That's not just gonna be enough. Not against that board. What's with these starting hands? But now I have the 2 mana play I can make, and then any land, so basically even a plains, gives me the Griff Rider. And if I happen to draw the red, I will have these things. So I'm going to keep it. I'm on the draw here, so I have one extra draw step to find a third land here. Come on, mountain, please. Nope, that was a red card. It's kind of the worst thing. So far, if I do draw the mountain, a red card will be fine. But okay, I'm not beating this thought here. I guess I can block that. But yeah, now I definitely need to. Definitely need to find a land. I mean, both draws were what, red cards then, weren't they? Come on, at least a land, but okay, that I can kill with the flame blast thing. This is the end of the event then. I mean, I'm taking only what, 5 damage here, I guess. This deals 2. But if I had a mountain here, the flame blast bolt would not only kill the twin blade thing, it also would exile it, so it wouldn't come back. But the opponent just curves out and I have a... Maybe I needed the Sigarda's imprisonment instead on the Heron of Hope. Yeah, I think I... Because I'm not gonna block anything, am I? No, that was a mistake. I guess that's what Tilt does to you. Because I'm actually gonna lose to the persistent specimen here. And this will transform into a 3-4 menace. Rebuilds their hand up. Yeah. Well, that's what happens. Opponent had 1 drop, 2 drop, 3 drop, 4 drop. And I missed a color. And also I missed a land drop. So that's what happens. Still, it was a 4 winner. And I guess the first loss was a... Well, no, I mean, my ranking up business was, that was pretty miserable. I got a 4-3, I got like a couple of rank progress here. I did like the deck, but because of the cheap removal, I mean, if I just had the red mana there, I had one removal in there, yeah, it would have made all the difference. But that's the nature of best of one. So if you stumble a bit and the opponent goes... And, you know, makes plays starting from turn 1. there's just no way you can beat it. And it's not like the hand was really a mulligan hand, because I had the Fleeting Spirit with two planes and a 3-drop. That, you know, if I drew any land, I could have played it. And of course, I had the red cards. So if I found a red source there, it would have been a pretty darn good one. I don't think it was a mulligan to 6, especially on the... I'm not even sure if being on the play or draw matters too much, but I was on the draw there, so I had an extra draw step available. But yeah, 4 wins is a decent result. It's just a not very good result when you are trying to rank up to Mythic, because I'm still here. Tier 4, 2 steps only here. It's a long way to Mythic. But the next event will be, I think, it will be a traditional draft, yes, and then after that, again, a premier draft. So thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.